Welcome to this video on content tagging in SharePoint 2013. There are new requirements that affect all files on the Inside NCDOT and Connect NCDOT websites. Current files, as well as files added in the future, must be tagged for the type of content in the file, as well as for type of security. This video demonstrates how to understand, choose, and apply those tags. In SharePoint 2013, each file that resides on either Inside NCDOT or Connect NCDOT must now be tagged for business content type and data security classification. Let's look at data security classification first. In the tagging interface, you simply choose between unrestricted and restricted. The tags for business content type are far more extensive. There are 13 genres that contain approximately 145 business content types. In the tagging interface, the first 10 genres are listed. Click this down arrow to see the last three, and click the up arrow to return to the top of the list. Once you decide which genre to use, click its arrow to display the business content types within it. For example, click the correspondence genre to see its business content types. And here are the business content types for the forms and templates genre. In this case, there are more than 10 types, so click the down arrow to see the additional values, and click the up arrow to return to the top of the list. As you start your work with business content types, you may find it useful to have a hard copy to refer to. Here's an example of such a list. You can find a similar list on the Data and Content Management Program page of the Enterprise Architecture website. Why is tagging required and why is it important? It ensures that your data is well understood, you can consistently and easily find documents, the right people access the right data, and NCDOT adheres to legal mandates. Let's review how to apply these tags to a file. First, select a file to tag. We'll use an image of a lighthouse. Click the File tab and edit Properties. In this library, Checkout Check-In is turned off, so you won't need to check out files to edit properties. Let's tag for type of content. Click the double tabs by business content type. You are probably used to selecting from a drop-down, so this is just a bit different. Expand Illustrations, Pictures, Visual, and Audio Aids. Click Pictures and Photographs as the business content type, then click Select and OK. Now let's tag for security. Click the double tabs by data security classification. If you prefer, you can double-click Unrestricted instead of clicking Unrestricted then Select. Click OK and Save to store the tags. Let's do one more example to see a few different options. We'll use a roadway monitoring report in PDF format. Instead of using the ribbon, you can click the ellipsis by the name of the file, click the ellipsis in the callout, and click Edit Properties. In the business content type row, start typing roadway. Matching tags appear. Click Roadway Reports and Recommendations. This approach will likely be quicker if you already know what tag you want to use. In the Data Security Classification row, start typing Restricted. The matching tag appears. Click Restricted and Save to store the tags. If you need to tag many files at the same time, you can use Quick Edit to do this efficiently. Let's continue to use the library where we've already tagged two files. Click the Library tab and Quick Edit. Scroll down to see the rest of the files. Here are a few ways to enter values. Click inside the Roadway Reports and Recommendations cell, click and hold the autofill handle in the lower right of the cell, and pull it down one row to copy the business content type. Now, click inside the Restricted cell, grab the autofill handle, and pull it down to the next to last row to copy the data security classification. You can also copy and paste values. Click inside the Roadway Reports and Recommendations cell and press Ctrl-C. Then click inside the DMV cell and press Ctrl-V to paste. In this row, click inside the Business Content Type cell and begin typing Roadway. Click Roadway Reports and Recommendations when it appears as matching text. Click outside the cell to save the value. What if you decide that the content type should be something else? Click inside the same cell and press the Delete key to delete the value. Now begin to type Guidelines. Click Guidelines as the matching text, then click outside the cell to save the value. If you need to delete several values, you can use the autofill handle to copy blanks. Can you enter an invalid value? Try entering highly restricted in a cell. The red exclamation icon contains an error message that you must select from an existing term, not enter a new value. To correct this, click the double tags and begin to type restricted in the text box. Select the matching term and click OK. If versioning is turned on in the library, a new version is created for each file whose properties were modified. If you want to tag multiple files at the same time and you know that most of the files have the same content and security tags, ask your designer or the web services team to set up default values for the library. Here's a library where default values have been defined and Checkout Check-In is turned off. Let's upload a few files and view the properties that are assigned by default. On your desktop, navigate to the files you want to upload. Use Click, Shift, and Click to select 6 contiguous files. Press the left mouse button, drag the files to the SharePoint library, and release the mouse button in the Drop Here area. Once the files are uploaded, dismiss the confirmation message. Note that each file has a business content type of sign-in sheets and a data security classification of unrestricted. If needed, you can edit a file's properties to override the defaults. Open Quick Edit to change the business content type of plan from sign-in sheets to plan. Click inside the cell, click the double tags, and begin to type the word plans. From the matching terms, click plans. Exit Quick Edit. What makes a file restricted instead of unrestricted? What's the difference between plans and planning documents? Data stewards have received training in data security classification and business content types, so if you have questions, find the data steward for your area and ask for assistance. In this video, we've examined the new tagging requirements for business content type and data security classification. You've learned how to choose and apply the content tags, and you've learned where to go for questions. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log into Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC Training Group. Thanks for watching.